time for G2 versus Godsend Overpass. Apologies for the delay. There was some disputes about server location between the two teams, and here we are.
Didn't take 5 hours though, like back in my day, when the disputes for EuroCup matches would take 5 hours. Because the admins, well, because back then you didn't have anti-lag, so the advantage you get, you would gain, was ridiculous if you had like a really big ping advantage. And secondly, the admins sucked. So no admins were like authoritative at all, and it'd be the top teams in Europe, so that they would always like, you know, be sucking up to the teams and players, trying to be, you know, trying to be nice to everybody. That's not how you make decisions, James.
It's not.
So it would take forever, and then people would start doing stuff like an admin would start to force them onto a server, then they would start suddenly having ping fluctuations. You know, like people would do that, and it would just last for hours. It sucked. EuroCup clan searching. That's how it was 10 years ago. More than 10 years ago, James.
I don't know how people would not just be like, screw this, I'm going.
Because you want to win the match. You want to win EuroCup. It's the most prestigious online cup at the time.
5 hours. How do you talk? What do you talk about for 5 hours?
It's just constant disputes.
that sounds good. That sounds ridiculous.
I just don't know how it would take so long, but it was notorious for problems like that. Could often happen. Also, people had worse internet generally back then as well.
That's true.
So that's like that's also an issue that could happen. Like, because even if someone had decent internet, they could have a routing issue, and because back then there was no proxying. In fact, in modern games now there's no proxying, which I don't understand. But I guess it's because anti-lag is pretty good, and internet's just generally better. Infrastructure is generally better across the world. So
yeah,
the old days, good old days.
There we go. So Overpass is finally coming shortly, and we were supposed to show. Well, for those of you who are unawares, Dan has been talking mad smack for ages, right?
About what?
Just in general. You're just a nasty human being, Dan.
Oh, okay.
And so we've taken it one step further with the James versus Dan series. You may have seen a teaser on Twitter, on TinterTube. We were going to show it after the last match, but we had to restart the stream, so we will probably show it after the next match. So make sure you stay tuned for that. But first, we have some Counter-Strike to play at some point.
Why are you looking around yourself just in a... You're throwing me off here. I don't know.
What?
You just started looking behind.
I'm waiting
you
for the match. See?
All right.
Look at that. You could not ask for more perfect timing. Right then, let's get started. G2 on the T side. I'll never forget that round of Shoxi on the pistol going crazy on this map. Godsend putting the numbers towards Connector. We've seen this before. Schneider off to a good start. Coming under some criticism recently. JW taken down, going for a push in Connector. Pronax and Schneider are still there. RPK entertaining people while the team move upstairs. That may leave Flusher isolated around the toilets, but they're coming in for the flank. Godsend realize it, push, but RPK patient as ever. Headshot machine. Not just Scream or Shox on that map. They've got on this team, sorry. Flushing now, last man standing versus three. And he will get taken down. What the mouthful I was trying to get out there was Shox, Scream, and RPK. All headshot machines. All headshot machines.
Yeah, and I think update by updates, they've had buffs slowly but surely, you know, hitbox updates. Updates to make tapping more viable, all these kinds of things, slowly but surely. You know, the updates have been going in their favor a little bit, but also they generally have been. Oh, that's a bad miss. They've been generally,
that's,
you know, improving
miss
as a team, as a unit, becoming more versatile as individuals. Scream in particular is a much more complete player than he used to be, which is really, really good to see. It has allowed G2 to progress much quicker, and you don't often see that. A setup like this for G2, they've got 3 MAC-10s and 2 MP7s. That's a very interesting setup to have. You would at least see usually like something else, like maybe a Galil, maybe even someone with an AK, or, you know, just to mix stuff up. But they have all SMGs here. I guess they just really want to maximize the amount of money that they make in this round, because that's what it would do. No matter who gets a kill here, they're going to get that SMG bonus for the kill. Juicy monies. Extra $600 for you if you are to make a frag. And Godsend, so far, unable to do much with the deagles that they have. This has been a good round so far from G2. You know, they just pushed up A long. They removed the ability for Godsend to do all that much. Crims gets one kill, but I think G2 are very happy with how that round went. And, you know, brilliantly, they can just do the same sort of thing. I mean, they have awesome weapons for Kevlar-less players, helmet-less players. It should be even better this round if they just do exactly the same thing. So, not the best start in the world for Godsend, and G2 are very scary on their T side of Overpass when they really get going, and this is the way for that to start.
Godsend deep, but weaponry is limited. Weaponry is minimal. And weaponry is gone. On to the next one. So let's see. We're not going to have AWPs on this run for the CT side. Only JW with a helmet. Looks like Body will roll with the... Oh no, picking up the AK. So G2, not going to mess around with SMGs. They just want full headshots at maximum range. Again, MP7 SMGs, good against helmets, but they have the damage fall off, which I have to note as well. Flusher, so far so good. Two kills for him very early on. G2 charging, looking for the engagements and engagements they will find, but Flusher ready and waiting. He can back off now, as G2 are in a lot of trouble. Ooh, so close to Pronax face. But not quite for Shox. It's going to take some individual prowess to get G2 out of this current spot they're in.
That's what they have, though. That is something that they definitely have in spades. And it's cool to see Godsend, you know, they're just backing off completely. They do not want any part of any shenanigans. They are just going to keep their advantage, force G2 to run into a bombsite where they're going to be forced to run into the crosshairs of maybe two players at the same time, meaning, you know, making it somewhat impossible for them to trade effectively. And that should be the round for Godsend. So long as they don't get picked, they are completely fine in this position as G2 move on to the bombsite. And here are the first grenades. It's going to be so impressive if G2 can come back from this, to be honest. Maybe with the help of Nade, something can happen. Shock gets himself Flusher. The rotation starts to come in. More nades here for G2. Really, really nice to be able to maybe get them in position to plant, but the bomb is lost, and their chances may also go with it. There's only 15 seconds to get the bomb planted.
And the CTs will continue to push and take everyone else down.
Easy, easy round. After these two kills, at least.
Yeah, Flusher, well, I wouldn't say he closed the round up, because you can never say that when you have Shox and RPK alive, or Shox and Scream. But definitely put them in the right direction. So that's the first buy round taken by Godsend. It's a better start on the CT side after losing the pistol. Early smoke grenades for Godsend. Once again, those of you who know it, have a look at my YouTube channel. There's a nice execute from CLG in this area, a nice CT push. I'm not even sure if I have a proper name for my account URL wise. I think it's Armtower CS. Anyway, scream down to the Tech Nine. All of G2 outside B at the moment, and JW's seen all he needs to see. Flashbang goes down. It's going to slow down the plays as well as a Molotov. Does Crim see Shox on short? He's got to be careful. If he goes into the corner by the wall, Shox will see him. Shox is dead, and so is pretty much everybody else. Scream of the Tech 9. Except the AK, but he can only take the one player down. 3K for JW. That's a good run for Godsend. Pick up an AWP as well.
Yeah, the money sucks for G2 now, and they've taken control straight away back from G2. And you never quite know what you're going to get with G2, I feel like. Like, for example, in the... last season of ECS, where G2 eventually ended up being the winners, we were struggling to see... They realistically were quite unlikely to even qualify for the LAN finals. It would look really bad for them. Mm. So it's just really unpredictable, the GTLC, online, on LAN. But the nature of Godsend recently makes it also quite questionable as to how this series will even go. And it's a very important series, I think, between these two teams, because... Ooh, that's pretty nice from Shox. Let's see if they can get anything else done. But between these two teams, I feel like they're in the same kind of tier at the moment in the league. Probably middle table is where I would see them right now from their current performances.
Yeah, one criticism of G2 despite their peaks of late. Hold on a second. Let's see what Shox can do. It's Shox and Scream, both with Deagles, actually. So this could be quite something. Scream has made his way towards long, and he knows where the bomb is, coming in for the flank, but Schneider's ready for it. Leaving Shox towards B. Shox maybe trying to draw some attention away, but it's too late now. JW continuing to duel with him. And there is Flusher on short, so that's been taken down. So yeah, one criticism of G2 has been that their style is, you know, has a shelf life, basically, which is the same criticism of Envy, where they were just running and gunning, and they had a very good run, Envy, in fact, but eventually it came to an end. And strategy and tactics prevail for the time being. It's almost like a Marvel universe. You've got the kind of good versus evil. The swing of power goes almost the way of G2. Flusher getting the first kill. Flusher and Schneider go down though. And now it's an early advantage for G2. JW hunting, trying to get advantage back for his team. And indeed, there it is. Very fast rounds here. Not often you see such exchange of fire so early on Overpass.
Well, one thing Godsend like to do is they do love to get aggressive towards A. We've seen that quite often before in the matches we've seen of them on Overpass. Buddy's in a nice position here to close things down for G2. A minute to play with. However, both players are already present, so he's going to have to go for the plant. Are they going to just go for the push? It looks like they're already creeping. They're not going to buy that it would be potentially a fake. Oh, Buddy, can he get in amongst them? He needs to try to cut off these angles, get one at once. There is the first one. JW falls, and Buddy might be able to do this now. Pronax is in a very worrying position here for Godsend, and boom, there it is. Buddy with a snap there. Beautiful clutch there for G2. Buddy with the 3K, and yeah, that's really interesting.
Yeah, looking like a nice pickup for G2, the new boy Buddy. G2 having good success. His aim is pretty sharp here. Boom. Very nice stuff. Typical French aim. Nothing but headshots.
And I mean, Godsend of two AWPs, two CZs, and a UMP. Kind of an interesting amalgam of weapons. It's not going to work out too well, though, for Schneider. There was no immediate support for him to trade there.
Yep, he was deep with the AWP flashed. Still managed to shoot somebody in the face, though. Not often you see Schneider AWPing. That AWP, I think, will be taken away by Shox. So an AWP on both sides. The best AWP is the one that you steal from your opponents. Oh, dear. Oh no, that's so awkward when he turns around just as you're going to knife. The worst thing, but Flusher gets the kill. Molotov is going to be pushed by RPK, and Flusher can't get his gun out in time. That CZ with the nerfed animation will be the death of Flusher on this occasion.
And if he got the instant kill, he would have had time there to actually be okay in that engagement. So it's kind of funny that that actually made the difference, I think. Because if Flusher had more time, I think he really would have been okay. But it's still a very doable round for both teams. JW spotting the presence on A long. From G2 and the push in the back there from, I think that's, yeah, it's Crims. He is going to give a lot of information here. He's going to hear the running down the stairs. So they should be making a rotation towards B now. The players on A, at least one of them could make. Like JW could go down there. He has the AWP too, so that's going to be quite useful from the high angles, the elevated positions. Although, are we going to get a smoke there? Looks like we might. So G2 covering all their bases as they pull off the execution of the push onto the bomb site. JW can see nothing.
He knows his teammates have got short B covered though. Scream down to 3 HP. And now Pronax is flanking from Monster. RPK is looking away. And Pronax is just back on to get the kill with the UMP. Tough kill, but he gets it. Again, Scream 3 HP, but JW's got the AWP, so it's awkward for both sides. And indeed, a CZ will prevail, leaving Body alone, leading more headshots. Crims is low. There goes Crims. Instant trade from JW. And Godsend come back to winning ways. Again, it's really, you don't see such violence and brutality in Overpass. Neither team fearing each other. I like the style matchup of these two teams.
Yeah, and I don't think that Godsend would be too scared of just going for the consistent pushes towards toilets. I'm trying to think which opponent it was against that they play. I think it may have been, was it NIP? I'm not sure what exactly the matchup was, but they played very aggressively on toilets. They kept trying to take down a player to never allow the T's to be able to run a play. But just the anti-eco now. charge into Monster. Looking a little bit scary there. I mean, already one player lost. The bomb might go down here in this position with the smokes to cover. Bomb has been collected. Looks like it will go down indeed from body. So that's job done already. Kill and the bomb down. I think that's a pretty good result here for G2.
Absolutely. Will Godsent wait for these smokes to disappear? I think there's a defuse coming in the smoke, actually. No, not just yet. Biding their time. Yeah, dangerous approach with the smokes. They're trying to limit damage. JW saving a teammate there. So Godsent, yes, the bomb went down, but they only had one player die, which is a plus. Still rocking with the double orbs. Now G2. I was going to say, will they try and circumvent these AWPs? Maybe with a fast play, but Smiths is back on the AWP as well. Doesn't mean they won't do a fast play, but does make it less likely. Schneider going towards long with his AWP. Flush and Pronax moving into connector. Krims and JW towards B. JW's instantly gone for a short B play. Very aggressive positioning. Very aggressive positioning from Godsent.
Yeah, they love it. And so do I. It's very, very good to see on overpass. A lot of teams play pretty scared. The most complex overpass is the aggressive overpass. And generally, I think you can make that statement. Playing aggressively creates more variables, generally speaking. So you have to be very smart.
Uh-oh.
The flick. Oh, it was coming in from JW, but too slow for Shox. And Shox will be creating presence here for G2 towards B. He's going to walk straight in as well. Interesting, because Krims is going to go into sewers to try to see if there's anyone in that area to allow his teammates to come to help him from the door spot. And Shox is on the angle. Surely he gets this kill. Easily done for Shox. And now, is there going to be rotation? Because the bomb can just still walk into A. This is really problematic. Shox is killing everyone so far. And Schneider is going to find body. So all of a sudden, it looks so good for G2. But now it's just Scream.
Scream versus 3. 35 seconds. He's got the bomb. This is doable. We've seen some interesting smoke attempts on overpass. That's not as good as Wenton's one, though, which actually popped inside the tree. It was fun to rip him about that. But what can Scream do here? He's got one player in the stairs, and yeah, he's limiting the time he can have to plant the bomb. Unfortunately for him, no plant on this occasion. Godsent take the round. Obviously, he was trying to go for a fake smoke, but I don't know. I feel like on this map, if you're going to go for smoke fakes, I feel like you need to have like four actual fake smokes from different areas.
Four is a lot.
It is a lot.
So all your smokes, man.
Not four smokes at the same time, but I mean, okay. you know how to throw a fake smoke from four different places, like from long, from toilets. From short B, you're like around a T-spawn area or something like that. Maybe playground, so you actually do a smoke which may draw people away. People keep throwing them at the tree and the tree's not cooperating with them, Dan. 6-4, 10 rounds in the bag already.
Would we call that like a cluster smoke or like the cluster bomb from Worms?
The cluster bomb from Worms was the best thing.
It was so satisfying. The cluster bomb from Worms is the one. Okay. Worms is awesome. It's been a long time. Pretty easy stuff here from Godsent. Holding pretty strong positions. Schneider's in a little bit of trouble. They do get close, but he's got support from JW, so it will all be okay in the end. And G2 will concede that round with their save, as they likely thought they would. But now comes the AKs once again. And, I mean, with two AWPs, with the spawn that Flusher has on the AWP that he's carrying at the moment, he's got to get the timing in. I imagine Schneider gave it to him because he's got the fastest timing here with the AWP. He's going to go down connector stairs. So if we have a look at Flusher, if he's going to be successful, there is players nearby, but no one peeking. But oh, he finds the angle on the gap. That is glorious. JW as well picks up a kill. So this is a great way to start things off here for Godsent.
Schneider taken down as Flusher escapes. Flusher cannot save his brethren. He will abandon him. And down goes Flusher as well. So again, such fast rounds, so rare to see on overpass and very refreshing. See if the duels continue. Pronax having a look. Gets taken down by body. Hard to find a weak link on this G2 side when it comes to headshots. Smith's flying through the air. And he will be taken down. So Crims has been afforded a great opportunity now. Nantel 1 versus 1, JW spotted, but he is playing a very dangerous game. But Scream hasn't found an edge shot to talk about just yet. No fear from JW. But he's playing against what makes sense. It doesn't make sense for him to continuously peek against Scream there.
No.
So he would probably expect Scream to be preparing to reposition or something. But there
we go.
I
think it's just JW thinks.
Just JW thinks. Well, he has got a kit. He's got a smoke grenade as well. But he has no idea where Scream is. But this plant often leaves T's in the same position. Oh, he's gone too far, Dan. He's gone too far. Not going for hero defuse. Scream's going for the peak. And JW's going to hold. Scream doesn't believe. He thinks he's left.
Oh, no.
Did he not hear?
Oh, my goodness gracious me.
Did he not hear it the second time? He was close enough. He was definitely... I mean, we heard it.
That is really interesting. Oh, my God. What a way to lose a round.
Do you know what? He must have seen... I think what happened was he saw that the smoke went past the bomb, but there's still range for JW to be in the smoke and defuse the bomb.
I would love to hear Godson's comms after that. They must be ruffling and a healthy dose of LeMayoing.
But there are those tentacles as well. You have the defusing tentacles, so you can see some of the defusing. Oh, well, that's a shame. It's a shame for G2 in that situation. I would like to see some more smoking of the choke points as well, but there we go.
Wow. This is so good. This is consistently happening, that Godson are able to get these early frags, and they're going to win the round straight away. And the cool thing about Godson's style, because
wow.
I love the style that they have on this map, is that they put teams in this position where at the start of the rounds, okay, maybe they'll lose a player, but you're always going to lose a guy every time. There'll always be a T dying. Sometimes maybe two T's dying. And if you put most teams in that position, some teams are really bad when they're the initial plan that they had, or the drills, or the whatever structure that they wanted to run. Now it's just four players, or now it's just three players right at the start of the round. It just completely throws you off as to how you're supposed to take certain positions, because now you've got to adjust everything. Like really early into the round, it's just so off-putting. So I love that style. I think it really abuses teams that are weak at calling.
Interesting that Schneider... I mean, we've seen a lot of Overpass recently, but we don't have time to talk about Schneider right now because there is a push through Connector with a number of people and the bomb is headed towards toilets. Now there is a position for Schneider to go for a flank. I was going to say he was a bit further back in the forward long position and would be more susceptible to flashbangs the way they're thrown over by most teams. Holding the off angle for the time being. Not sure if you can hear the running and jumping around, but Flush is still on long. Having a look-see.
These positions, man. Oh, he's pushing as well. This is just nuts, isn't it? Oh, wow. Free kill. Godsend are so amazingly positioned right now. Okay, Flush's position's a little bit sketchy. Is his barrel visible? I guess it's not. He'll probably get a free frag, and that should be the round now, because what are they going to do? How do they get... They're just getting wrecked, James. They're getting completely destroyed. They're getting isolated one by one by awesome positional plays by Godsend.
Yeah. Godsend are not allowing G2 to play their game under any circumstances. I think Godsend have the perfect personalities for a matchup like this. This is really interesting stuff. 10-4, solid score for Godsend so far. But G2 still have buys. We still have a buy in the last round of the first half. How long until we see more violence? Schneider and Flush are not done just yet. They are changing their approach somewhat, just slightly. Schneider on the high ground, and now he's the one upper for this round. Forced to move back a bit. See body limited to the Tech 9. Will be the scout for this round.
They're like, can we have a little bit of the map, please? Please allow us to have something. And they will have their wish granted because everyone from Godsend is playing far back now. They've given up forward positions completely. It's what an interesting match so far. Really interesting.
Yeah.
Quite fun. Quite a fun one.
Very fun. So again, Chocks over towards B. Directing the rest of the team. JW ready for body. Been running around with the Tech 9, making a nuisance of himself for a while. Now he has been told to shut up. Two players along with the bomb. Shox is walking into B now, trying to get a sneaky opening. Will he have good timing? Pronax with a grenade in his hand will get taken down. That's going to pull a rotation, but Shox has made his exit. Not going to overextend. 40 seconds for G2 to make a play here. No info for the CTs outside of B, which means their defenses will be forced to stretch. The bomb's rotating. But to where?
Yeah, I wonder if Crims will catch as Shocks over towards the Sewer's position. He doesn't actually catch him, but Flasher holds it down. He gets the bomb. That's all the information for the rotation. He is going to have to be quite concerned about his flank, although he is just taking player one player down after another. 10 seconds. It's impossible for them to win the round now. And Godsend close it down 11-4. And G2 got just blown up by the style of Godsend. They got completely blown up. Just this aggression. Just forward pushing everywhere. I love it. It is so fun to watch.
Yeah, this is really nice stuff. It's nice stuff from both teams. You know, the styles make fights, as they say, and this is enjoyable regardless of who is winning. So G2, will they have a repeat of that notorious round at ECS? Shocks is indeed leading the charge towards that area. Yeah, he wants it. Is he going to get it, though? Spots the leg on Crims. Doesn't see the other two players moving past. So that might put him into trouble indeed. He thinks there's one up there, but there's three. Now he's forced to back off, but not really safe for him to make it to the toilets. So he'll be moving into connector. No one's there, fortunately for him. Three players moving down. He might go on the hunt. Body gets taken down elsewhere by Flusher. I think he's picked up a P250. Yeah, he's been made a raid boss. He's got P250 armor. And again, that's in terms of headshots, that doubles his range over the Glocks.
Shocks has to make this play work. He gets the bomb. That is beautiful. Shocks is amazing at Counter-Strike. And he claims the bomb. And this just throws a massive wrench into the works here. Although he will fall back entirely. Shrider's just going for it, man. He's like, I'm going to take down these two players. Then we'll plant on the A-bomb site. It's all going to be fine. I promise Crims, it's going to be fine. We got this. And he's actually causing somewhat of a rotation here. As Shrider's just running around all over the place, making his presence very well felt by the CTs. This could actually work here for Godsend. Shrider doesn't care at all, Jay. He's just going for it. And he's created a 1v2 here. A winnable situation for Crims.
But is he making the right play? Smiths is on Graffiti, and he's going to hear this running, which is going to allow Scream to rotate. Will he have time to plant the bomb in this situation? Scream's on the site now, so unfortunately, Crims' gamble isn't going to pay off. Smiths delivers the final blow.
And no bomb down as well, which means the force buy, as we would expect a force buy at least.
It was cool to finally see a P250 armor on a T player in a pistol round, because you rarely see it, and again, it does double the range, just shy of double the range of headshots versus a Glock on a pistol round. One shot to the head, essentially. Three UMPs, all SMGs for G2. Again, we've seen some changes recently, an increase in MP7s being picked up over UMPs, but not with G2. They will be wielding the $500 cheaper UMP. Better armor penetration, worse moving accuracy, and rate of fire.
Yeah, it definitely stands up better against rifles. Versus rifles, it stands up better than the MP7, I would say. That's for sure. I think the difference is quite noticeable. And there is Shocks. He's going to find himself the entire team. I'll have you, and you. Didn't know about JW though, right behind him, but that's going to be okay. That's the end of the round, and Shocks, he made some nice money there. Cheeky $1,800 for him. And Godsend are going to start to lose their lead. It's starting to whittle away. They have to save this round, and it's unlikely they'll get anything done. So, somewhat of a mirror so far, you know, to the beginning of both halves. You know, just for the switch up is just the team that gets the first three rounds. So, pretty standard stuff at the moment. I'm just looking forward to seeing when the AKs come out onto Godsend, you know, how that's going to, what kind of approach they will go with. Because I did recall their CT aggression from past matchups, but I can't remember being quite as impressed by their T side, to be honest.
Let's see what more the T's can do. Never mind, they're all dead. Off to the next round. So, we have SMGs. What will be kept from G2? I can't imagine RPK is going to stay with an MP9. No, he isn't. So just like the T's did, well, I guess it was G2 at the beginning. Yeah, so they went for the... they didn't keep the SMGs on either side. Going for... Ooh, it's the Bardolph smoke, Dan. You have just witnessed the James Bardolph smoke of Monster. You're welcome. That's how I like to smoke Monster.
Smoke in the mouth.
Because then it's harder for the tease to exploit versus the one that's deep into the B bomb side. I was surprised though. I thought it was going to go through. Maybe they did it by accident. I don't know.
Well, it's a slow approach from Godsent. They've got some presence on both sides of the maps, but G2 are playing very passively overall. And this off angle is always going to be strong. You can see a bit of their body before they can see you. And that will be two kills there for G2. And Godsent have to basically make the mid-round call, and they have to take some big risks here to get themselves back into the round. Somebody's got to win one versus one. It will not be JW. So this round is... I would be very surprised to see Godsent doing anything in this round at this point. They would really like to do some damage because G2 just had two rounds where they picked up those rounds very cleanly. If Godsent don't have any economic impact on their opponent, then they're really going to start to feel that in some of the later rounds, and it's going to be much harder for them to get momentum back into the series. And there is Shox adding insult to injury.
There goes the bomb. Schneider will get one frag, and that will be his lot. So G2 in a good position to even up the numbers, even up the scores, maybe even take the lead. Three of the players on the CT side have 6 or 7K. That bodes well for the future. Keeping money in their pockets. Godsent. Two deagles. They don't have much going on. They want to maim the economy. Oh, the train denies the HE grenade of body. He's going to go for a one-man flash, but that's been denied by the train tracks. So Flush is not blind at all, and he will punish body for his foolish insolence.
Yeah, pretty bad round for body. So right, though, so the rest of his teammates are going to be clearing things up for the G2 side. And it's just formality, really. Flusher, he wants to be able to get into position to do damage with this rifle of his, but one of the easier ways to do it is if he has help from a teammate who has just a deagle, maybe he can draw some fire. Flusher can peek out, get the frag. That's a very handsome deagle. Flusher, can he get something here? He's got 33 health. He's got some Kevlar, so the aim punch won't be a big deal, but the health will be. And he's dead. So, chances are very limited now.
Definitely Schneider, chances limited when you're dead.
Schneider will try to continue the legacy here of the M4, and he'll do well. Gets a frag out of it. So, Grimms now, maybe he can get one of these players. Deagle! Okay, now things are looking much different. RPK is one bullet away from death. Will they suspect that there's a player on the barrels? Maybe not, because Scream is taking all the attention away here from Crims. He picks up the M4, and there it is. RPK shows himself. But it ended up pretty good, actually. Three kills from the two players. So that's a nice way to...
Oh, man.
...get every player the failure.
Denied. Yeah, and the flashbang. The flashbang landed on top of the train track, so it doesn't flash anybody below. So got to be aware of those details. So Smith is deploying the smoke, and he's completely messed it up. He has missed by a country mile, Dan, which I'm sure you're familiar with. So
it's a mile.
Godsent won't capitalize on that failed smoke. But he's in position anyway. Scream with great timing and some nice flashbangs. Could have been two. One will do for now. However, were it two, maybe Smith wouldn't have gone down. Now goes Shox as well. So there's trouble for Scream and Co. Just enough bullets to get that kill. Last bullet will do it. Again, we're going to rounds of early frags. And a dollar frags. Scream's boss a friend. Two versus two. There's more than a minute on the clock here. It's so weird and yet so awesome. There goes RPK. What's happening to the economy of G2? What's happening to the numbers? They're all going down.
Very strange round. Very, very strange round. Not quite your standard orthodox round. And Godsent find their way back in because of it. Maybe you want G2 to play more passively. You know, when they force Godsent to work the map, they've actually been finding more advantages. So looks like they might go back towards that. Smith is in a very passive position towards the restrooms there. So he's going to be looking just for an op shot and then to fall back, perhaps get a little bit of info and be safe. Shock's looking to take away sewers. The peek here with the orb. Lovely stuff. And there's the leg. Flushing gets caught. Can't get out. He is committed. Does some damage to both players, but that is not the frag. And now Smith gets his turn. He knows there are players nearby. Good timing there. Oh no! Bad timing on that one though, as he will go down to Grimms as they move forwards. Godsent pick up the pace now towards the A bomb site, and Scream goes down without issue. Now things are starting to be problematic here for G2.
There's a flank possible for a body, but will there be anyone alive when he gets there? RPK putting in some good work, left Schneider on 12 HP. But Schneider's already in an advanced position. Crims just needs to survive and get off the corner. Nobody needs to peek the angle now because Schneider is in the back. And he's going to hit a rotation. He's going to have sound cues for days, and it will be a free kill for Schneider. An important round for the Godsent side. You see the money, what it's done to G2. 2 to 3K. They are in a horrible position at present. Godsent look good for 14.
Yeah, it should be pretty easy for Godsent to get there now. And I don't know, though, with their T rounds seem very volatile, generally speaking. It comes down to so many individual fights, which is awesome, but not so awesome if it's not so awesome from a consistency perspective, at least from what they've shown us. Their CT side had much more structure, and it was really nice to see how it abused G2's play style. Or just generally, I think it's quite abusive as to how people want to play this map on the T side, but how they're so cognizant of this beautiful position. It's like, that's not ever happening. This is just not ever happening here for G2. Great hold for Godsent. They predicted this well, and now Godsent will be pretty happy bunnies, I should think, moving it forwards. I mean, Scream's always good for it, but this is quite something to ask. And he's dead.
Fourteen to nine, unless Smith has the round of his entire life. Yeah, it's 14 to 9. So never mind.
Indeed it is. So Godsent looking pretty snazzy at the moment. G2, are they willing to take risks here? They don't have any orbs, so playing passively is going to be a little bit more difficult because of that, and they won't be able to effectively or feel as confident on the picking game as well. So they'll have to rely on some funky setups, rifle setups, forward rifle setups, and they're going to go with the boost here. Used to be very in vogue, but not so much anymore, as it kind of fell out of fashion, but that means that it can work again now, maybe for a little while at least. We have seen it a few times recently, whereas otherwise it had disappeared.
Yep, every now and then, keeping the opposition surprised. A few interesting... I like what the toilets has introduced into this game, actually. A lot of different setups in one small area. And places which... it's quite curious how the human repeatedly doesn't check certain spots. Flusher creeping, getting a nice angle. I'm not sure if JW's seeing a shoulder there or anything, but there's a rotation coming in now from Shox over towards the A site. The boost retains from Godsent. You can see Shox trying to look over towards the short door there. Ooh, Flusher could be spotted. He must have rung the alarm bell with body going for the spray. But do they have a read as A now? They're pushing short B to CTs, or at least body is. Godsent have been forced backwards, but again, there's still this boost over towards A. It's been spotted, and it has not achieved much. Smith will trade, and he's down 6 HP. He cannot survive, not even with a smoke down.
This does not bode well. Shox has to make something happen here. Crims goes down pretty quickly, but he's lost his support. Body is now in a body bag.
Wow.
And that's going to be the frag for JW as well. Shox dead, and G2 are getting kind of crushed overall here. Godsent have crippled their economy, and they look very good to take this last round for a very easy 16-9. Wow. I say very, very easy. I don't imagine it ever feels easy against G2, but the scoreline at least means that there was less trouble less turmoil than otherwise could be expected. Deagle, Scout, Famas, 5-7s. Sad times here for the Frenchman. Godsent will make their way forward and run into the Famas of Shox, however. So a little bit of foray into the aggression there for the CT side of G2. And now all the way back, pick up the advantage and then all the way back onto the bomb sites. Very passive now from G2, waiting, forcing Godsent to execute a set piece onto one of these two bomb sites. And they are just going to wait for it. They're not going to play the information too heavily. They're just going to sit and wait.
G2 playing deep with these pistols. Well, that's a problem. Man advantage is gone. Weapon advantage was never there to begin with. Smiths is very isolated. That's a very nice flick onto Flusher, though. He's done some damage for his team, despite going down. But they can't pick up any weapons. The weapons are too far back in enemy territory. Down goes Shox. It's just Body alone with a 5-7 and a smoke grenade to find three players, and JW is not going to allow it. A great performance. A very entertaining game of Overpass. Quite unlike many of the matches we have seen recently with the slow rounds. Just brutal, unrelenting violence from both sides.
Yeah, I love the style of play where you want to eliminate players early on from the CT side. Because on the maps where you can do it, it's awesome. I mean, this is one of the reasons why a lot of people really struggle with Cobblestone, because you just don't have options for that. But maps like Mirage, Cache, Overpass, and even to some extent, but not as much, Dust 2, there's always that element that you can get aggressive. You can try complicated plays with a lot of risk-taking. But if you have a lot of skill, a lot of individual skill at your disposal, then it can really be an effective game style. As we saw, G2 were constantly in a position where they would lose players really early into the round. So that makes it much harder for you to then have presence all over the map, which means it's easier for the CTs to then have pushes elsewhere on the map to then get information and then set up flanks. And we would always see G2 have to slow down, and it gives time for the flank. And then the positionally, Godsent were just winning every time. So it's a really cool stylistic exchange.
Yeah, and that was the pick of G2. That was their pick against Godsent. The next map's going to be Train, which is the pick of Godsent. So perhaps Godsent are in a very good position to win both. I mean, I say very good. It is G2 and Train. They're not going to be any slouches on.
Oh,
so
yeah,
we'll have to see what happens there. Now, I think it might be time for the James versus Dan video.
Oh, really?
The first episode, indeed.
Alrighty then.
All right. Well, stay tuned, guys. Have a look at the James versus Dan video and let us know what you think. See you after the break.